Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Starting today's video, we have the launch of Starlink 12 as well as a bunch of other standard SpaceX updates to look at. Then it's over to Boca Chica once again with infrastructure updates, SN8 testing and other Starship bits and pieces. Let's head straight in and get up to date. After having many delays, SpaceX once again tweeted on Monday that they were standing down from the launch of Starlink 12. They said they would be targeting a new window on Tuesday. Then finally, yesterday, the Falcon 9 booster took to the sky carrying another batch of 60 Starlink satellites.
Zero. Ignition. Lift off.
The booster which flew this mission was B-1058 and was flying for the third time. As expected, it then successfully landed on the Of Course I Still Love You drone ship.
Looks like right in the center, that marks 61 successful recoveries. Third time for this booster.
Once the satellites had been deployed, SpaceX tweeted a video of the deployment. Musk responded to this tweet with information about the Starlink public beta. He said, once these satellites reach their target position, we'll be able to roll out a fairly wide public beta in northern US and hopefully southern Canada. Other countries to follow as soon as we receive regulatory approval. Musk made a mistake in a tweet saying that this was the fourth flight and landing of the booster. When corrected, he said, yes, it was the third flight of this booster and third flight for active half of fairing, aiming for 10 plus flights of booster and fairing by end of next year. Then he was asked about any significant differences in terms of recovery between flights. Elon Musk responded with, "We are not seeing notable differences yet. I think the boosters could probably do 100 plus reflights. Some of the small composite helium tanks would need to be replaced, maybe turbopump hot sections." Somebody tweeted about a significant reduction in turnaround time for Falcon 9 boosters. Elon Musk previously mentioned a 24-hour turnaround time with a Falcon 9 at some point, so they asked him if we could see that anytime soon. Musk said roughly a week or two turnaround is all that's needed to meet max launch demand. Starship Super Heavy is designed for reflight in less than an hour. There was another tweet posted by SpaceX with this shot of the same Falcon Heavy booster we saw recently, I believe. They said, a Falcon Heavy side booster that will support the USSF 44 mission for the Space Force next year completed a full duration static fire test last week at SpaceX's rocket development facility in McGregor, Texas. In response to this, they also pointed out something in the picture by saying, in the background is Grasshopper, which SpaceX used to test technologies needed for a propulsive landing of an orbital rocket. They gave some more info in response to this with, since Grasshopper's first flight in September 2012, SpaceX has landed 60 Falcon first stage rocket boosters and reflown them 42 times. Recently, we found out about another October launch that wasn't on any publicly known manifest, so it was assumed to be an undisclosed mission. Turns out that the National Reconnaissance Office announced that they were the customer. Apparently, this launch is currently targeting liftoff of no earlier than October 25th. With even more future launch information coming out, SpaceX have been selected for yet another contract. Along with another company, SpaceX will build 4 of 8 satellites that would be able to detect and track ballistic and hypersonic missiles. There was a tweet from space reporter Michael Sheets which says, Bank of America, SpaceX saves as much as $20 million per Falcon 9 launch by recovering the boosters and fairings. If a rocket completes 10 flights over its lifetime, the company will be able to save over $196 million given current price levels. The Motley Fool has posted an article about the reduction in costs for using flight-proven SpaceX boosters. They said, initially, SpaceX had agreed to launch these government GPS satellites for about $97 million. But in return for being permitted to fly reusable rockets, SpaceX now says it can cut the price it charges the Space Force for the next 2 launches by a total of $52.7 million, a savings of more than $26 million each, as BreakingDefense.com reported last week. I also want to add this, soon the Roadster will finally get close to Mars. Thanks to WhereIsRoadster.com, we can see where Starman and Roadster are currently in their orbit around the Sun. With those many but interesting updates covered, we can now see what's been happening over in Texas. Starting today, we have something I've not shown much of recently, the new orbital launch mount. They recently finished pouring concrete into the supports for the mount and so have mostly been doing groundwork nearby. At the landing pad, engineers have been continuing to do concrete work, presumably in preparation for SN8's flight. In the construction yard, there was a container spotted that has a label saying aft actuator. There was a new component that arrived on a trailer and thanks to Jack Byers' editing, you can see in the bottom left what this might be. Nearby the ground fabrication building, some new unknown components were spotted arriving on a trailer. Engineers are continuing to work on the new crane and have recently been preparing to move it. Also in the production yard, after having recently worked almost non-stop on the high bay, the giant crane known as Bluezilla was seen taking a rest. We have a small Starship or super heavy piece spotted with this four ring stack sitting outside near SN5. Also next to this ring stack, the barrel section we previously saw labelled Lock Stack 1 Booster was moved. Let's take a look at the existing Starship starting with SN7.1. After having recently been pressure tested to the point of failure, the tank was pulled off the transport mount, literally. Then, whilst laying on the ground, this digger was spotted going at the destroyed tank to destroy it some more and break pieces off of it. With SN7.1 now completely over and done with, SpaceX are looking at SN8 to continue their development progress. This Starship tank has been waiting at the launch area for quite a bit of time now as its testing begins. During the window from Sunday evening through to Monday, I believe SpaceX performed a successful ambient pressure test. However, early on Tuesday morning, they appeared to be gearing up for the first proper cryo-proof test of this tank. Although some hour or so before the end of the testing window, the tank was seen double venting, which usually indicates an abort. Then, yesterday evening and through to early this morning, they had another attempt at the cryo test. They started filling the tank and the LOX tank started collecting ice as it got colder and colder inside the tank filled with liquid nitrogen. Then later into the testing window, they started venting, but the methane tank started collecting ice as they filled it with super cold liquid nitrogen. Sometime later, the tank was seen starting to defrost, and what we assumed was that they were getting towards the end of the test. And so, this test completed the first cryo-proof test of SN8. Next up for this tank should be a static fire with what I assume will be three Raptor engines, since this vehicle should get free. The final Starship to look at this episode is SN11, at least I presume this is for SN11. Firstly, you can see that a new lower bulkhead was seen sitting on the sleeving mount and next to it was the ring stack. You can see that the ring stack was then lifted and placed over the thrust dome to form part of the aft section. Whilst this could be for another prototype, I think it's safe to say this is possibly destined for SN11. I like to always thank the incredible Mary or Boca Chica girl for her time and dedication filming this stuff. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team doing great work behind the scenes and with their live streams. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.